This is the Honda Civic Hybrid. Those of you who have seen some of my videos on hybrids in the past know I don't really like them. I'm not a fan. They're kind of boring, they're slow, the CVT transmission is loud, and this Civic is no exception. It's just as boring and just as loud, and I don't really see the value in it. What I do like about it though is that it's a sedan. Now, most hybrids like the Prius and like the Insight, you know, have the five-door hatchback look, which, yeah, you know, is all right. It's very practical. But if you really want to stick to the sedan look and still get good fuel economy, it's a good way to go. So, you know, EPA numbers and I don't really get along. This car is rated 44 city, 44 highway. I actually was able to get 42 in relatively normal driving. And if you compare that to a regular Civic, that might get a combined 30, 32 miles per gallon. So you're talking about 10 miles per gallon difference. Over a typical year, driving 15,000 miles, you're gonna save about $400 with this car. But it's gonna cost you about $3,000 or $4,000 more than a regular Civic. So start doing the math, that's like a 10-year return on your investment. That's a long way to go to recoup the cost of a hybrid. And you're gonna be driving with a CVT transmission that, quite frankly, is loud, it's noisy, and it just doesn't work. It just sounds like you're driving a dustbuster. So one way you can distinguish the Civic Hybrid from its non-hybrid siblings is this blue line. Of course, you know, blue is the new green, I guess. The wheels are different. You got a little spoiler on the back. Just some different ground effects overall. Anything just to make the car a little bit more aerodynamic. They've also done some things to lighten it up a little bit. Again, this is how you get to that 44 miles per gallon. Interior wise, it's pretty much the same. You have another information screen that tells you what's going on with the whole hybrid system, but otherwise it's a Civic. It's basically a Civic with a hybrid motor, $24,000 as seen here, cloth seats, not exactly the deal of the century, and not exactly setting the world on fire with fuel economy. What I really don't like is Honda used to be one of the cool car companies, used to have really cool dash, and they have done some things here to improve the overall look and added this secondary screen here. But this radio area is, I just really struggle with it. It's a pretty large area for not a lot of buttons. I really prefer the navigation screen in here, but that's about a $1,500 to $2,000 option. But as far as the drive, pretty uneventful. Again, mentioned the CVT transmission. It's just not a very good transmission. It just has, it's a continuously variable transmission. It just makes this whiny noise, and it's not a whole lot of fun. By comparison, you look at a vehicle like the Hyundai Sonata Hybrid, they use a regular 6-speed automatic, which I think is much better. You know, speaking of the Sonata, that's a really good comparison for this car. Look at the non-hybrid Sonata. That car, nicely equipped, $24,000, that's what you're gonna pay for this car. Yeah, you got about an 8 mile per gallon difference, you know, as far as fuel economy, but what a much bigger car, a better warranty, overall, a much better value. One vehicle you should definitely put on your shopping list is the Volkswagen Jetta Turbo Diesel, the TDI. That car is wonderful to drive, very engaging, it's great fuel economy, and I think really blows the doors off of this Honda Civic Hybrid. Honda makes it very easy to tell if you're being efficient with your driving. To the left and right of the speedometer, you have these indicators, and they change color based on your driving style. Green means you're being efficient, blue, not so efficient. So let's give it a quick go here. I'm accelerating, it's blue. I'm decelerating here, now I'm in a regen mode, and it's turning green, meaning I'm being a good citizen. So there you have it, the Honda Civic Hybrid. Yeah, I couldn't really make the numbers work for me, but maybe you could make it work for you. I think a lot of it has to do with how you feel, you know, how you feel about yourself driving this car. Obviously, you know, less harmful pollutants, and yeah, a little bit better fuel economy.